What is up, guys? DonCut97 here, bringing you a brand new Halo MCC challenge guide. Today we're taking a look at the weekly PvE challenge, Ecumene Abodes, which is to complete 3 campaign missions set on Forerunner Installations. This needs to be done on normal difficulty or higher, and some of the available campaign levels are Halo, Assault on the Control Room, Delta Halo, Uprising, The Ark, The Covenant, Forerunner, etc. The level of choice for this is going to be Halo 2's Uprising, as it's the shortest level on that list for the available campaign levels. I'm playing on normal difficulty here, and I have the Sputnik Skull enabled. Since we're going to be using a grenade jump that happens early on in the level, this will allow you to get out of the map and walk to the cutscene's target zone where the cutscene will play. This will take about pretty much 3 to 5 minutes per attempt on this challenge, so it is not that time consuming, which is very nice. Usually you play this beginning part of the level kind of normally, where you're going to go over here, grab the energy sword. I like to use my active camouflage a lot throughout this first section, since there's about 8 brutes here, and I don't like to deal with brutes in Halo 2, since they are just a pain in the butt to kill without having a precision weapon like the carbine. Your camo runs out around right here, so I like to go up against this wall and let those 2 brutes come out of the structure, letting my camo recharge before I run around this corner, jumping over these 2 brutes and making my way up to the doorway. These 2 that are up here, though, I usually do kill them, or sometimes I'll just kind of walk past them. There is an elite teammate that will rush out from inside the structure after those 2 brutes. Usually that's a good time to go out and kill them as well and grab one of their brute shots, as you will need a brute shot before you exit the structure. Once you come into this room, though, I recommend going into classic graphics and jumping on this light fixture and doing a crouch jump up onto this ledge where the 2 grunts are. The reason I'm saying go into classic graphics is since the textures and geometry do line up for the classic graphics, it makes that crouch jump a lot easier, as in Anniversary, not all ledges have the textures and geometry line up correctly. So there might be some areas where there's actually a ledge, but you don't see the texture, and vice versa, where there's not a ledge, but there is textures there. That just happens because of how Anniversary is built upon the classic games, and that also happens in CE. This room right here, I usually kill both of the brutes. Luckily, once you kill one, usually the other berserks and runs away. For me, this time he had a brute shot, but there was multiple other brutes before those that had brute shots, like the 3 brutes that had ran out of the previous room. If you had killed one of them, they also would have dropped a brute shot. As long as you have a brute shot with at least 5 rounds in it, you're fine. Honestly, you could get away with just having one brute shot, as the brute shot round is what you're actually going to use to do the grenade jump. This room here is probably the only room I actually try to fight the enemies in, just because there's that turret that's kind of annoying. Right here, I still have 5 rounds, so as long as you have at least 5 rounds by the time you're outside, you are fine, as you're going to use a combo of some of these brute shot rounds and grenades to displace these guys, since they're just kind of annoying to constantly deal with. You can also just stick them with the plasma grenade, as I said. As long as you have 1 grenade at this point, now you're fine. Go around this little barrier and use your camo, jump onto this rock, and you're going to go over to this ledge. Make sure you are in classic graphics, as it'll see this ledge is a lot easier to see. You're going to face down with the brute shot and send 1 round into the ground, and that should launch you up onto this ledge, and you're just going to follow the pathway I'm taking to get to the target zone for the cutscene to play. That is pretty much it. This is a very simple challenge once you get the hang of it. For the more novice players, this might be annoying at first, but you will get the hang of it and it gets really simple. You're just going to come over here to this little black spot right here that I'm about to crouch on, and that'll actually load the cutscene. That's all, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Remember, if you did, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.